Well, we are continuing in the book, Daily Abundance, Increase, Abundance, Overflow, and More Than Enough. We did a little detour on Friday for Juneteenth. Give me a thumbs up, give me a high five, give me a heart if you were okay with the detour that we did talking about liberty and freedom on Friday for the Juneteenth celebration. If you missed that, go back and to our YouTube channel and you can see any previous messages without any commercials on our YouTube channel, and that's Dr. Pulley. Yes, just go to YouTube and put in Dr. Pulley. Also remember, if you're looking for a smaller version of the message, a 1 minute version of the message, you can go to Instagram or Twitter around 7:30 and it'll give you a 1 minute version of the message, and also my personal Facebook page. All right, you ready for today? We're on page number 20 and this is day number 13, and we're talking about transportation currency, the currency of transportation. Our scripture is Matthew chapter 21 and verse number 5. Again, that's the gospel according to Matthew chapter 21 and verse number 5. It says, "See, your king comes to you, gentle and riding on a donkey and on a colt." And that was Matthew chapter 21 and verse number 5. Our affirmation is, I receive the good and perfect transportation for where I have to go. I receive the right and perfect transportation for wherever it is that I have to go. Come on, affirm that again. I receive the right and perfect transportation for wherever it is that I have to go. Now, Jesus is our way shower. Jesus is our example of what it means to be fully human and fully divine. He is the pattern son. He is the one that we pattern our lives after. And so Jesus dealt with transportation. And so because Jesus dealt with transportation, he is our way shower, our example, our model, our standard rule about transportation. Jesus' primary mode of transportation is that he walked. He walked to the various cities and towns, and having been to Israel and Jerusalem and those different surrounding cities, they are not very far from each other. They may sound like a long way off, but when you actually go there, these cities are very close. Like, their cities would be more like what we consider to be towns. Like in St. Petersburg, you got Kenneth City, you've got So give me some more places. You got different little cities within the greater St. Petersburg area. So that's how it is when you go to Jerusalem and Judea. It's like they're little towns. They're not really big cities. They're more like towns, communities, neighborhoods within a particular city. And so Jesus walked. That was the primary mode of transportation of people during Jesus's day. That's why they also had foot washing, because people would walk the dusty roads. They were not paved, and so people walked the dusty roads, and when someone would come to your house, you would show them hospitality by having their feet washed. So that would make them feel comfortable, that would make them feel relaxed. It's the same way today we offer somebody a glass of water. Can I offer you something to drink? They would offer to have the person, to wash the person's feet. And so therefore, the transportation and all of that kind of went together. So Jesus's primary mode of transportation was walking. He also, when he came to Jerusalem towards the end of his life and ministry, he came on a donkey and a colt, which means that he also had the transportation of a donkey. That was a mode of transportation that he used as he entered into Jerusalem. There are also prophecies and revelation about the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords coming into the new Jerusalem on a white horse. And so therefore, that's another model of transportation. And so as we look at this, we can see that God is concerned about my transportation. Affirm with me, God is concerned about my transportation. Not that I just get to places, but God loves me so much that God is concerned about how I get to the places that I go to. The Bible says that God will perfect those things that concern you. And so transportation is a concern. You need gas for your car. Amen. And when one of the gifts that we gave yesterday was a gas card, because that shows that we care. Nobody's car rides on nothing. Either you need some gas in your car or you need to hook it up to one of those electronic charging stations. But there is some type of energy, and they cost too. They're not free. That there is some type of energy that is used in terms of transportation. And so One of the currencies through which God flows through to bless you is transportation. You may have never seen transportation as a currency or a way that God is blessing you, but be without transportation and you will realize that it is a currency through which God is flowing to bless. Anybody ever been without transportation, been without a car or your own vehicle, and you really saw that it was a mode of transportation? Give me a thumbs up, give me a high five, give me a heart. I'm great, tell a story today. Give me a thumbs up, give me a high five, give me a heart. If you may have, you were taking transportation for granted until you didn't have it, and then you realize that that is one of the ways that God is blessing me, that abundance and prosperity is coming to me through transportation. Pulley point number one, local transportation. No matter how you are traveling, whether it's a bus, whether it's a car, whether it's an Uber, whether it's a Lyft, whether you got a limousine service, a car service, whether it's a train, a subway, a metro, any way that you're able to get from one place to the next, and you don't have to struggle with that, that is a blessing. And so begin to thank God for your local transportation. Pulley point number one is local transportation, that God is able to bless you and flows through transportation to bless you. Even if you're riding in a scooter, that's a mode of transportation for you to get from one place to the next. A motorcycle, a bicycle, a scooter. If you have a public transportation service that picks you up, Care Ride, begin to thank God that there is transportation to get you from one place to the next, because God is flowing through transportation to bless you. Whether you got a used car, whether you got a hoopty, whether you got a brand new car, or whether it's a car that's new to you, thank God that God is blessing you through the mode of transportation. I made a choice. I made a decision about 4 years ago. I'm getting ready to be 50. So about 4 years ago, maybe not that long, maybe three, I made a decision to stop driving because I don't like driving. I'm not good at driving. And I've been in 13 collisions, car collisions, over my 30 years of driving. So I was 46. Since I started driving at 16, I drove for 30 years and I decided to give it up. I released and let go of driving a car being my mode of transportation. I've had wonderful cars. You know, I've had all kind of cars, top of the line cars, but I'm just not good at driving because, one, I have a challenge with spatial relations, understanding what can fit into it, but parking was a challenge for me. So I let it go. I've also been distracted while driving on my cell phone, getting a phone call, getting an idea for a message, an idea for a book. And before I know it, I've let my foot up off the gas and I done rammed into somebody's car. So I let it go. I said, I'm going to use Uber and Lyft and have people drive me. And I'm grateful for the people that drive me around. I'm grateful to be blessed with having drivers. I'm grateful for Elder Sheree. I'm grateful for Shepherd Mother. I'm grateful for my Uber drivers, my Lyft drivers, and I'm grateful for my feet, which is the primary mode of transportation. I'm like Jesus. I walk. I live in an area where I can walk to most of the places that I have to go and the things that I have to do, and that's my primary mode of exercise, walking. So thank God for local transportation. Can you thank God when you got gas in your car? That is a blessing that God flows through. When you have money to be able to get your car repaired, routine maintenance. Let me tell you, people get cars. I got a Jaguar and I could pay the payment, but the maintenance on that Jaguar, I needed God's divine intervention to keep up with the maintenance if I needed a part for that car. And so I'm telling you that one of the ways that we're not seeing that God is blessing us is through transportation. And if you are not satisfied or not happy with your current transportation, God is able to bless you with better transportation. Give me a thumbs up, give me a high five, give me a heart. If you know that God is able to bless you with better transportation, that God is able to open up the doors and give you favor where you can get a new car, a car that's affordable, maybe you don't even desire a car payment. I've been in a situation where God has blessed me with a car paid for and I didn't have to pay anything. The car was just given to me. I'm talking about God flows through transportation as a vehicle to bless you. And I'm going to tell this story. I'm going to tell it now since I'm talking about local transportation. I remember I was 19 years old and I was a spiritual leader. We had a small storefront church. I was pastoring at 19 years old. And, you know, I had a car. I've had a car since I was 16, my own car, not sharing it with anybody. And we had this pastor that was speaking for an afternoon engagement. Yes, we used to have afternoon service when I first started being a spiritual leader. And so we had, you know, we thought we were big time. We had our hospitality staff and our parking staff. Yes, at 19 years old, we were college students. We had our parking staff, our hospitality staff, our adjutants and armor bearers, and we were all set up for this guest speaker to come and be. You know, we had everything arranged, his parking space reserved, the brother out there ready to move the cone and direct the man. We thought we were really doing it big time. And so we were waiting and we're waiting, like, what is taking them there late? You know, we were very on time. And the bus stops at the end of the corner and we see the pastor and his congregation that was our guest speaker and guest congregation get off of the MTA, Mass Transit Administration bus. Him and his whole congregation got off of the bus on the public transportation. And I'm telling you, not in their faces, but behind their backs, we laughed. We was like, oh my God, what kind of pastor is that? Well, he's riding the bus and his congregation is riding the bus. I mean, and we're full of pride and we're arrogant because we got cars and, you know, him and his congregation are coming to a guest engagement on the bus, public transportation. And when service was over, they were all on the bus stop waiting for the bus to come back and pick them up. Not pick them up, but it was public transit, pick everybody up and take them to their destination. And we just thought that was just, how are you going to be a pastor and you're catching the bus and the cargo? We just laughed and we just laughed and we laughed. 2 weeks later, I was in a car collision. And my car, my brand new car that I only had for 3 months, it was a Hyundai. And that was when they first came out. I was in a collision that caused my car to be totaled. And not only was my car totaled, but I was upside down in the payments because, you know, it depreciated when you take it off the lot. And so I owed more on the car. I didn't have gap insurance then. Give me a thumbs up. Give me a high five. Give me a heart if you ever experienced the blessing of gap insurance. Yes, I'm talking about transportation today. And my car was totaled. And for 2 weeks, you know, I got a rental car. And once they tell you that the car is total, then you have so much time and you got to turn that rental back. And so I was upside down in the car. I owed like maybe $1,500 on the car. So I didn't have the money to get the new car. I didn't have a down payment. And so I'm praying and I'm saying to God, surely you do not desire for your servant to have to catch the bus. And I was like, you know, I'm your servant. I teach, I preach, I minister to your people. You would not have me in the city of Baltimore getting on a bus on public transportation. And then while I was praying and meditating and levitating, it came back to me. The vision of this spiritual leader and his congregation. I said, oh God, please, I said, God, forgive me for laughing at him. Forgive me for talking about him. And I'm going into all this forgiveness that I'm asking God for because I'm, you know, I had talked about the guy and I'm pleading. Let me say this. When you know that you are wrong, do not be afraid to ask for forgiveness. Acknowledge that you are wrong. You know, you can't just move and glaze over stuff. When stuff comes up, it comes up and out to be healed. So I had to ask for forgiveness for making fun of that spiritual leader and his congregation. So I thought I was all good. I was ready for God to bless me because I had asked God for forgiveness. And I'm telling you, I have a real relationship with God, not a fake one. Because some of these things that people say, God, tell them, I'd be like, but God told me that if you do not desire to catch the bus, that you need to call the pastor that you were laughing at and talking about and ask for forgiveness and tell him what you did. I'm like, oh my God, I was like, God, he don't even know. And God said, do you desire to catch the bus? God was talking to me just like I'm talking to you. He said, if you are too prideful and too arrogant to ask for forgiveness, then you can get on that bus. MTA is going your way. And so I prayed and I was mustering up the courage and I called him on the phone and I said, Pastor, I'm just calling. He's like, everything fine? I said, oh yes, the message was great. He said, the honorarium was fine. I said, it's not about, any of that. I need to ask for your forgiveness. And he said, for what? I said, I was laughing at you and I was talking about you and your congregation because you were getting off of the public MTA bus. And there was a silence that came over the phone. And I thought that he was really getting ready to go in on me. And what he said is, I admire your integrity. He said, because I didn't know you were laughing at me or talking about me. He said, but the fact that you would call me up and ask for forgiveness for what you did. And I told him about my car and what happened and the whole thing I just told you. He said, but the fact that you would be obedient enough to God to ask for forgiveness and put yourself out there like that. He said, I'm going to pray with you that God blesses you with a car. Now, this man don't have a car, but he prayed with me and God that God would bless me with a car. And I tell you, within 3 days, I was gifted a car. I'm talking about no car payment, no car insurance. I even got gas for a year. I was blessed with a car, but I had to humble myself, recognize that I had done something that was not the highest and the best, that was not the right and the perfect. And because I had done it as it related to somebody's transportation, and this is a currency that God flows through, I had blocked my own currency of transportation. I had blocked the flow of God in my life as it relates to transportation. And so once I cleared that flow by asking for forgiveness, for laughing and talking about him, then God opened up that portal of transportation to be able to bless me with a car with no car payment, didn't have to pay the car insurance, and got gas for a year. And I'm telling you that transportation is one of the currencies that God flows through to bless you. So pulley point number one is local transportation. And let me tell you, God will not only bless you with local transportation, pulley point number two, God will bless you with national transportation. I'm talking about planes. I'm talking about jets. I'm talking about trains that will take you from city to city and from state to state, that God will flow through, giving you discounts, giving you membership statuses, giving you points. All of these are currencies through which God flows through to bless you. And so currency of transportation is one of the ways that God bless. When you can travel from city to city, whether it's a plane, whether you drive, or whether you get on a train and you can travel, whether it's a jet that you're able to travel from city to city, that is a manifestation of abundance. When you have the resources, the ways and the means to be able to plan a trip and go on a trip and not worry about the finances for that trip, that is one of the currencies that God flows through in order to bless you. Pulley point number one, God will bless you. Local transportation is a blessing. It is a currency. Pulley point number two, national transportation. Maybe you stayed local. Maybe you stayed on one side of town and you haven't opened yourself up to vacation and traveling to different cities, that God will open up the window of heaven and make ways for you to be able to travel beyond just where you live. And God will give you the resources to be able to travel nationally. Pulley point number three, God will also open up the resources for you to be able to travel internationally. Yes, I'm talking about transportation currency, and I am blessed and I give God praise that I've been to the majority of states in the United States, and I've been to probably about 15 different countries, and my goal is to get to every continent because I know that transportation is a currency that God flows through in order to bless you. So open your heart and your mind to be able to travel, not just locally, but nationally, and not just nationally, but internationally, that God is able to flow. Maybe you got a dream trip that you've always desired to take. Maybe it's a cruise that you have always desired to go on. Open your heart and your mind to know that God is able to flow through various currencies to provide the transportation, the ways, the means for you to get wherever it is that you desire to go. And so I am holding in conscience with you today the abundance of transportation, the ways, the means, the resources to travel and to go wherever you desire to go, locally, nationally, or internationally. Those are my 3 points today. Locally, nationally, and internationally. I am grateful for every trip that I've ever been on. I'm grateful for Donald Beasley, my travel partner. Just trips. We're planning on going to Alaska for 10 days. I'm paying on that trip right now. And I know that transportation is a currency through which God plans to bless us for 2021. I know y'all looking like ain't nobody traveling now, but I'm talking about 2021. I got that Alaskan cruise. I'm going to Paris, France, 2021, because God flows through transportation as a vehicle to bless you. So open up your heart and your mind. Money is not the only currency that God has to bless you. You can get free trips. God will bless you with free trips. People will gift you cars. People will gift you gas, and they will gift you maintenance and all everything that you need as it relates to transportation. It is a vehicle through which God flows through to bless you. And however you desire, just begin to open up your mind to transportation and better transportation. I am holding the conscience with you that you can travel wherever you need to go effortlessly with the ease and breeze of spirit, that the very desire of your heart. Maybe it's an anniversary trip or a birthday trip that you desire to take, and you've been struggling with how you're going to afford it. God, I'm saying to you, it's flowing through the vehicle and the currency of transportation to bless you to go wherever you desire to go, wherever you need to go, locally, nationally, or internet. As much as you can open your consciousness up for travel and transportation, God is able to do exceeding abundantly above all that you could ask or even think, according to the power that God that works in you. And so I open my heart and my mind. Anybody's heart open, anybody's mind open today to see transportation as one of the currencies that God flows through to bless me. I open my heart and my mind to receive worldwide travel. That's what I affirm. Worldwide travel, adventure. Yes, I open my heart and my mind to receive it. That the door is already being opened. The way is already. There's a whole great big earth out here. The earth is the Lord's, the fullness thereof, the world, and they that dwell therein. See as much of God's earth as you can see. Travel to as many places and experience new people and new experiences, different languages, different foods, different cultures. Allow your mind to open up to know that this is not just something that you have to watch on TV. I'm prophesying to some people right now. And this is not just something that you have to watch on TV, but you can travel. Yes, you can get a passport and you can go places and you can do things that God is not just in the four walls of the church. And that's one of the reasons I believe that we're not having physical services the way that we did before as much, because we have got confined to think that God is just in the four walls of the church. I've experienced some of the greatest spiritual experiences in nature, on a plane. Give me a window seat and I can hear God so clearly. I can write a book, you know, away in God's country, just with the grass and nature and the trees and the birds and the water and just seeing the glory of God in different places. I'm telling you, transportation and travel is one of the currencies that God flows through to bless you. And I am open to receive vacation. I'm open to receive worldwide travel, adventure, going to places I've never been, meeting people I've never met, having new experiences. It's all up to you and your consciousness. And if you can see God flowing through the currency of travel and transportation to bless you, you can experience in your life. I love you so much.